Hey guys, it's me, Jackie. I'm coming to you today with another dream that I had on June 8th, 2012. I'm going to make this fast, okay? I'm going to go through my dream, and I'm going to give you the word that came to me, and then I'm going to share with you the scriptures, okay? But I'm going to make this as quickly as I possibly can. All right, so let me start off by saying that this dream could be made into a movie, because it went on just like a movie. I could probably write a book about it. It was just so unbelievably clear, you know? It starts off in a house on the shores of a beach. I remember it was a fishing community, and I could hear the seagulls. And we were cooking inside, me and my family, what appeared to be breakfast. The smell of chorizo, for all my Mexican friends out there that like chorizo, the smell of chorizo was overwhelming the entire house, so I stepped outside on the porch, which faced away from the beach, with Maribel. To our left, we noticed a very low-lying, dark, ominous cloud creeping along the tree line towards us. I noticed that the seagulls were extremely silent. There was no noise. There was no wind or sound of seagulls. We didn't say a word to each other. It was almost as if we were paralyzed where we stood, never taking our eyes off this cloud-like object. As it passed the house and continued on its way, we suddenly were able to move and go back in the house. It's evening now, and we are watching television together, when our show is interrupted by breaking news. I know a lot of you have had dreams like that. And it was China on the news. Millions of people were locked behind a tall chain link fence, their faces white as ash, and their eyes red and swollen shut. There were streaks of dried blood on their face, and it was as if they were crying blood. We were all extremely horrified at what we saw. The next morning, Maribel and Maida and I decided we're going to go for a walk on the beach to the docks where the fishermen came in with their huge amounts of fish. As we were walking down the beach, we noticed a strange behavior in the others on the beach. Some were drowning themselves in the ocean, while most were just walking aimlessly on the beach. Their faces were the same as we saw on the news the night before. We thought, oh my gosh, it is here, it's here. We were careful not to touch any of them or make eye contact. They were not zombies, okay, but had characteristics of the zombie phenomenon. We got to the docks, and there were fish dead everywhere, but there was no fisherman in sight. The place seemed totally abandoned. We left the beach and took the small one-way paved road back to the house. As we passed the school football field, I noticed that there were people behind a huge chain-link fence that blocked off a portion of the bleachers. We walked down there, sitting and crying on the first bleachers closest to the fence, was Monica and her two sisters. Monica and her two children, and Anna and her three children. You guys, Monica, Anna, Maida, and Maribel are all sisters. So Monica and her two kids, and Anna and her three children were all locked behind this chain link fence. We began to cry and shake the fence. I felt so angry, and I wanted to try and help them escape. Just as I was about to grab something to cut a hole in the fence, Monica yelled at me and said, "It's too late. Run. Just run. They are coming, and they will catch you guys if you stay here." Kind of reminds me of my last dream I put out. I'm thinking, who is she talking about? We ran and went to the house to grab everything we could, and we ran until we could run no more. We stopped to take a breath by what looked like a five-story apartment building. Maribel and Maida was talking, and I was keeping lookout for some unseen enemy. Just then, in my peripheral vision, I noticed another dark cloud coming over the roof of this apartment. I looked at it intensely, and to my surprise, there were two large orange-reddish lights in the clouds. The lights were in the position of eyes. It really reminded me of War of the Worlds. I grabbed Maribel and Maida, and we hit the ground. I knew that if this thing saw us, we were dead. Luckily for us, it continued on its way. Next, we find ourselves observing a man lying on what looks like a dentist chair, and there's someone with us, and he explained to us what had happened. This man is not human. He is a host of what you call an alien. The worldwide pandemic was put in place by your very own leaders to weed out the weak. They do not want weak bodies. This is not the first time the human race has been enslaved by them. They think they are gods, and your leaders were promised years ago positions of power if they cooperate. Some survivors will not become hosts to to these so-called aliens, but slaves to their new world. And that's all I remember from the dream. And then today, this came to me. Today's church will soon find it hard to deal with its identity. Hold to your faith. Something wicked this way comes. Keep your eyes open and lean on God for understanding. It will be open to everyone and publicly exposed. Things are not as they seem. Do not fret. It all will be revealed. Those of you with eyes to see and ears to hear already sense it. Something smells fishy. There's an unclean spirit loose that will cause and is causing distress, trouble and confusion, yet it is not covered and hid. It is covered and hidden from you. You will see and hear of troubled times. Sickness will be in the land. There is much spiritual neglect and uncleanliness in the world, causing coarse and harsh personalities to come forth. A hedge will be set in front of you, but stand firm at the gap. Who will stand in the gap? Prepare yourselves for unpleasant changes and unimaginable trauma, overwhelming pressure and despair. Do what is right in the eyes of the Lord. Follow His word, and He will be with you. Do not idle. Though you suffer ill health, you will receive spiritual refreshment and renewal. There is a dangerous journey ahead of us, an evil presence nearby, but God's Spirit will be with us. Find your dwelling place. For a man in position of authority with evil intent will try to confront you. Worry not what you will say. The truth is in you. Do not be deceived. Demons are trying to completely take over. They are overwhelmed with hatred and revenge. Contagion is in the land. You are advised to not get carried away by such feelings. Though you are weak, do not be dismayed. Do not become enslaved by the spiritual battle which will spill over into our realm. There is a change coming that requires great effort on your part. It is something that will be difficult, but you can overcome. God will send His angels to help you. Though the flesh is weak, you love the Lord, and He will hold you up in your hour of need, so you will not be overtaken by man or demon. Okay, here are the scriptures that go with what I was given. Zephaniah 1:15. I went ahead and threw 1:14 in there. 1:14 and 15 says, "The Lord's great day of judgment is almost here. It is approaching very rapidly. There will be a bitter sound on the Lord's day of judgment, and at that time warriors will cry out in battle. That day will be a day of God's anger, and a day of distress and hardship, a day of devastation and ruin, a day of darkness and gloom, a day of clouds and dark skies." Revelation 6:8. "I looked, and there before me was a pale horse. Its rider's name was Death, and Hades was following close behind him. They were given power over fourth of the earth to kill by sword, famine, and plague, and by the wild beasts of the earth." 2 Samuel 7:16. "Your house and your kingdom shall be made sure before me forever." Isaiah 43:2. "When you pass through the waters, I am with you. When you pass through the streams, they will not overwhelm you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not harm you." Zephaniah 1:15. "That day is a day of wrath, a day of troubles and distress, a day of wasteness and desolation, a day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness." Isaiah 30:15. "For thus saith the Lord God, the Holy One of Israel, in returning and rest shall ye be saved. In quietness and in confidence shall be your strength, and you would not." Ephesians 6:10. "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might." 1 Corinthians 10:13. "No temptation has overtaken you that is not common to man. God is faithful, and He will not let you be tempted beyond your ability. But with the temptation, He will also provide the way of escape, that you may be able to endure it." Isaiah 41:10. "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." God be with you. Be strong and stay in Him. Thank you. God bless.